David Dunkel immigrated to the United States in his youth and attended the University of Kansas studying paleontology and went on to earn a doctoral degree from Harvard studying under the famous paleontologist Alfred Romer. After graduating, he became the chief paleontologist at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History, where he worked on arthrodires, armored fish from the Devonian period. He's best known today as the Dunkel in the gigantic armored fish named after him, Dunkleosteus. In 1942, during World War II, Dunkel traveled to Carter County, Montana to collect fossils from the Cretaceous Lance Formation of Montana along Sand Creek. And during the trip, Dunkel and his team excavated a beautifully preserved dinosaur skull that would become one of the most controversial dinosaur discoveries ever made. Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. And in this video, we are looking at the controversy over Nanotyrannus, a possible Tyrannosaurus rex youngster. Now, the fossil was collected by Dunkel was prepared for exhibit at the museum in Cleveland, Ohio, and it was fully described in a paper by the Smithsonian paleontologist Charles Gilmore in 1946. And he named the new dinosaur Gorgosaurus lanceus. The genus Gorgosaurus had previously been named for fossil dinosaurs found in Alberta, Canada, which are believed to be closely related to Albertosaurus. And these large carnivorous theropod dinosaurs are members of the same family as Tyrannosaurus rex, but from slightly older rock layers in the Campanian age of the late Cretaceous period. Now, Gilmore noticed that the skull bore many similarities to Tyrannosaurus rex, and it was likely from a similar stratigraphic position in the Maastrichtian age, the latest part of the Cretaceous period. Now, the best known Tyrannosaurus rex of that time was found in the Maastrichtian age Hell Creek formation, about 250 miles north of the new fossil dinosaur site. Yet the skull was less than half the size of Tyrannosaurus rex and bore more similarities to another small little specimen named Gorgosaurus sternbergi from Canada that was housed at the American Museum in New York. Now, the skulls of both Gorgosaurus sternbergi and Gorgosaurus lanceus have kind of long and slender, and they lack that big, bulky appearance of Tyrannosaurus rex and Albertosaurus. In 1988, the Canadian paleontologist Phil Curry, with co-authors Bob Bakker and Michael Williams, published a paper naming the Dunkel dinosaur specimen a new genus. They named it Nanotyrannus. Now, Phil Curry was actively excavating fossils from Alberta, Canada, and he had acquired specimens of Gorgosaurus from different life stages. And the Dunkel specimen from Montana had a number of differences from these specimens of Gorgosaurus. So the authors of this paper erected a new genus that they named Nanotyrannus. In 1990, the famous Tyrannosaurus rex specimen Sioux was discovered from the Hell Creek Formation on the Cheyenne River Indian Reservation of South Dakota, about 250 miles east of where the Dunkel specimen discovery site is in southern Montana. Now, given the proximity of and similar stratigraphic occurrence, many researchers speculated that Nanotyrannus was a juvenile specimen of Tyrannosaurus rex, rather than Gorgosaurus or a separate genus. Thomas Carr was the first to kind of formally suggest that Nanotyrannus was just a juvenile Tyrannosaurus rex in his classic revision on the Tyrannosaurid systematics. Now, in 2001, the Burpee Museum in Rockford, Illinois, funded a trip to collect fossils from the same area as the Dunkel specimen. And when they went out there, they found a second dinosaur, which they named Jane, that closely resembled the holotype of Nanotyrannus. Now, rather than identifying it as a specimen of Nanotyrannus, the researchers suggested that both specimens discovered in the area were juvenile specimens of Tyrannosaurus. In 2005, a science conference was held at the Burpee Museum, and Phil Curry and Michael Williams, two authors that actually had named Nanotyrannus, went to the conference, and they agreed that both specimens likely represent juvenile specimens of Tyrannosaurus rex. But not all researchers present at the conference were convinced, leading to a continuing controversy over the status of Nanotyrannus that has been heavily debated, maybe more than it deserves on the internet, between camps on either side. Now, further discoveries of juvenile specimens of Tarbosaurus batar from Mongolia, like the named genus Raptor Rex, which was reevaluated as a young Tarbosaurus, kind of highlights some of the changes that occur in large theropod dinosaurs as they grow up and mature. And a recent research paper has begun to chip away at Nanotyrannus further, supporting Nanotyrannus's juvenile status as a youngster rather than a different species. So this brings me to talk a little with you today about the science of ontogeny. Ontogeny is the study of an organism's shape or morphology from the time of fertilization from an egg through the entirety of the organism's full lifespan until death. Now, every organism undergoes changes as it matures and grows. And these changes are manifest in changes to the proportions and size of the various anatomical components of an animal, including the overall shape and form of an animal's skull as it grows and matures. Now, ontogeny is closely related to the study of allometry, the study of how things change as they get bigger or smaller. Now, one of the earliest researchers on allometry was Darcy Thompson, who wrote this famous book on the subject entitled On Growth and Form way back when in 1917. Now, Thompson developed a keen understanding of growth in organisms. As multicellular organisms grow, they add new tiny individual cells to its body. And the growth of these individual cells dictates the growth within each portion of an animal, which can change drastically over time. If one part of the organism grows more cells than another part, the shape of the animal will enlarge one part over another. The timing of the cellular growth of different parts of an animal results in distortions in the size and shape of an animal as it matures. And this difference in timing is called heterochrony, meaning different timing. Now, some animals exhibit isomeric growth, which means that younger individuals have identical proportions to older individuals, like they are mini versions of the adult form, just little mini guys. However, most animals exhibit heterochrony with non-isomeric growth. For example, human babies, have giant heads compared to their body, such that if you enlarged a baby to adult size, it would not look like a normal adult human in proportions. This is because the brain grows slower after birth than the arms and legs. In Tyrannosaurids, younger individuals have longer and slender skulls than their adult forms. You see this also with birds as well today. New research has looked at lines of arrested growth in the section bones of dinosaurs identified as Nanotyrannus, which allow researchers to determine the age of individual specimens. Like tree rings, these lines found in the compact bone are believed to be annual growth rings. Now, specimens of Nanotyrannus are estimated to be between 13 and 15 years of age by counting these rings, whereas adult specimens of Tyrannosaurus rex likely lived up to 30 or more years. Now, there's still a few people that still hold out that Nanotyrannus was a dwarfed version of Tyrannosaurus rex in a separate species. And they point to some differences in the teeth and jaw and the arm, and they evoke other dwarf species like the Channel Island mammoths, which are mini versions of mammoths that were isolated during the last ice age on the Channel Islands off the coast of California, where they evolved into miniature versions compared to mammoths on the continent. This type of dwarfism requires geographic isolation from the rest of the population. So the question becomes, was Nanotyrannus geographically isolated from the rest of the population of Tyrannosaurus rex, maybe on an island in the retreating Western Interior Seaway? Now, most specimens we've talked about attributed to Nanotyrannus come from the southeastern region of Montana, whereas a larger population of Tyrannosaurus rex has been found across a much broader geographic range. We've got specimens that go all the way, have been found all the way down in Texas, in Colorado, here in Utah, up in Montana, of course, northern Montana, and into the Dakotas. There's one specimen of Nanotyrannus that appears to break this idea, a mysterious specimen known as the dueling dinosaurs, which is a pair of dinosaurs, one being Triceratops and the other Nanotyrannus, that were found together in northern Montana near where some of the best specimens of Tyrannosaurus rex have ever been found, along the Missouri River. Now, this single specimen runs opposite to the idea of that Nanotyrannus was a geographically isolated population, and it further supports the idea that specimens of Nanotyrannus are just juvenile individual specimens, younger specimens of Tyrannosaurus rex. Now, the dueling dinosaurs have not been fully described in detail, and the specimen was found on private land, and it actually failed to sell at auction to a museum or to a private museum, and it's currently in storage. So hopefully sometime in the future, it'll actually be put on public display at a museum and maybe fully described in a publication. But I think it's amazing that we have enough specimens now of Tyrannosaurus rex that we can start to understand the growth and development of this iconic dinosaur. And I don't think this diminishes from the importance of these specimens. And in fact, I think that it makes them more special in being examples of juvenile individuals of Tyrannosaurus rex. Hey guys, so this is my first video of 2020, and I wanted to try something new this year for those of you who support me on Patreon. I've been trying to think of a way to give back to those of you who support me. So what I'm planning on doing this year is that I'm going to be giving away original artwork that will appear in each video that you support. So this week I'm going to be giving away a pencil sketch and watercolor that I did of the holotype specimen of Nanotyrannus that Dunkel discovered in Montana. And next time I post a video, I will draw from a deck with the names of those supporters who contribute to my Patreon page at a new $5 level or above that now appears on my Patreon page. So if you would like a chance to some beautiful original artwork of dinosaurs and other extinct creatures, click on the link in the description below. And if you currently support me on the $1 level, maybe consider increasing it to $5 so you get a chance to get an original piece of artwork. I'll draw from the list after each video, starting with the next video. So I will then draw two names for the next video, give you a chance to sign up. So there'll be two chances to win next week. I'm going to be hopefully making weekly or bi-weekly videos, uploading 2 to 4 new videos each month. So for those who currently support me at this level currently, log in and fill out your mailing address so that if your name is drawn to win this, I can mail this artwork to you. This includes my current EOHippus supporters, Fred Olney, Marlo Andreco, Magnus Solfang, Pablo Luzato Figuez, Max McGregor, Niso, Sean McCormick, and Emmett Larson. So be sure to fill out your address. I'll be making more videos on dinosaurs, paleontology, and geology, and I'm super, super excited to add more videos this coming year. And if you've not done so, please, at the very least, you can subscribe to my channel on YouTube so you can see more of these videos. Thank you for watching.